upgrade your life, upgrade your network.
I be in a loop, she be in a group. Brody want a friend, throwing alley hoop. Turn something to nothing, bro, I'm living proof. How can I lose when...
What's up, guys? It's Eric Spofford. Thank you for checking out the channel and watching this video. Today, I'm going to show you a full home tour of my very first mansion, which is located in Southern New Hampshire, about 40 minutes north of Boston. I've owned this place since about 2015. And so it is an unbelievable estate. It's about almost 15,000 square feet. It has 9 bathrooms. We have a private pond, a tennis court, an infinity pool, a hot tub, a game room, a movie theater, etc. I mean, this place is just enormous. First, I want to tell you the story. It's a story I've told on social media before, but I'll tell it again and give you a little more detail about how this home came to be. You know, when I got sober, I got sober in December 7th of 2006, and very slowly started to build my life back up. When I got sober, I was in a lot of legal trouble. I had burnt my life to the ground. I didn't have a lot at all. I had a couple of pairs of clothes that I carried around in a trash bag. I eventually was able to get a $550 a month apartment on Walnut Street in Nashua, New Hampshire, which is called the Tree Streets. If you're familiar with the city, any neighborhood called the Tree Streets is never a good place to be. Stay out of the Tree Streets. And so I was a habitual offender with my license because I kept getting in trouble. And after a year of continuous sobriety, I was able to get my license back, and I bought a car, and that car I bought for $400. It was a 1988 or 89 Volvo 240. And up there, this is a gated neighborhood. This is one of the most prestigious neighborhoods, if not the most prestigious neighborhood in the entire state of New Hampshire. And what I would do is I would leave the ghetto. I would leave my crappy little apartment in my terrible neighborhood where I really barely had money for food. I was struggling to get by heavily. And I would drive down here and I would pull over on the side of the road right up there. And I would get out, and you know, I was working construction at the time, and I'd still smoking cigarettes, and I would just lean on the hood of my car. And I remember I'd always get a Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee, and I'd sit there and I'd smoke a cigarette, and I'd just look around at these multi-million dollar homes that were being built at the time. And I would just think to myself and manifest and have the belief that someday I was gonna get to a place where I could live in this neighborhood. This very nice place. And you know, at the time, if I had told anybody that out loud, probably would have sounded crazy given the circumstances of my life and what was actually going on. And the point is that nobody's gonna believe in you unless you believe in you. And oftentimes they're not gonna believe you until you show them. People are gonna judge you based on results. They're always, in the beginning, they're gonna think, oh, that's unrealistic, that's crazy. They're gonna have a lot of criticism at times. And then after you accomplish it, you know what it becomes? Yo, I knew you could do it. I supported you the whole time. It's kind of crazy. But that was probably 2007 and 2008 that I would come visit this neighborhood and just dream and manifest and obsess about somehow, someday. You know, I started my business in 2008. I worked, put my head down, and I worked tirelessly. And in 2015, I purchased this home, which in my opinion is the nicest home in this neighborhood. And so you don't know, my message in this story is no matter where you start from, I started from below rock bottom. You have no idea if you're willing to do the work and you're willing to do the internal transformational work and put the effort out what your life can become. And so today we're gonna walk through the house. Let's check it out.
This is what, like I said, really sold me on the house, was this tall ceiling, having this Scarface type balcony. Those double doors on the other side of that balcony up there is the master bedroom. I just fell in love with when you walked in the house. But, well, let's turn it off. Here we got my at-home office right off of the living room and the main entrance. You know, lots of memories here. When I was selling my business, I had stepped down as CEO for almost a year to executive chairman, so I wasn't working out of the main office building anymore. And so I sat here and worked, you know, almost that entire deal through all 2021. This is where I spent a long time working in the past. I don't spend too much time in here anymore. I'm really not nailed down to an office. I've set up all my businesses that they operate off of my phone. As long as I have my laptop and my phone, I can operate off of Teams and Zoom and texts and calls. And so not too much time spent in here anymore, but lots of memories have been made in this room. You know, this room is the main living room. I love it up here. I spent a lot of time hanging out here. This fish tank I actually got for some sharks that I had. Those sharks got too big, which we knew they would, and we rehomed them to something that was a much bigger aquarium. And they're happy in the new setup, but we switched this tank over to freshwater. And so we got these big catfish that they're very cool. We got the little catfish in there. And you know, it's a pretty cool tank. We've got a formal dining room. You know, we've used this for Thanksgiving, and that's about it. We don't spend too much time here. It's all good. It's our second living room, and we got another fish tank. I love this tank. We got a quick story about this, right? We built this tank. God, we've had this thing a long time now. These fish have been with us for quite a while. And it was several years ago that I was standing here, and there's an eel in this tank, and I was had little pieces of shrimp called krill, and I was putting them in the tank and feeding the eel. And this lionfish, I didn't know too much about these things at the time, but this lionfish snuck up on me, and one of these barbs that comes off the top of them poked me in the finger. And I didn't expect it to be sharp. I didn't expect it to stab me. And I had my son with me, I have these fish tanks for my son, my oldest son. And he knows everything about them. And I looked at him and I said, Gavin, I just got stung by this fish. And he said, I said, what's going to happen to me? And he looks up at me with the straightest face and he said, Dad, you're probably going to die. I almost had a heart attack. But luckily, it wasn't too serious, but my fingers swelled up like the size of a sausage for about a week. It was incredibly painful. So I've actually been stung by that lionfish. And we still let him live another day, you know? But we enjoy this tank. We have this TV here, beautiful couches, very comfortable. We have our main kitchen area here. This is another selling point. When I looked at this house, when I saw this kitchen with the white marble, in the black cabinets, I really love that. That's a good portion of the house. What's left to see? We have an enormous game room. I'll take you up there. We have a movie theater. We have 4 bays of garage here. We have 2 bays of garage downstairs on the other side of the house. That's filled with toys. It's kind of a mess. I have a collection of 4-wheelers. I used to race them when I was a kid, so I have a whole bunch of them. I have snowmobiles with dirt bikes. That's all kept down there. I used to have a crazy collection of cars here in New Hampshire. I dumbed down the collection a bit for 2 reasons. One, I don't live here all the time, and so I don't spend as much time in New Hampshire as I used to. Which isn't really the main reason. The main reason is I didn't like the attention that I got here. My other home in Miami, I have nice cars there and we drive them around and there's cars like that everywhere and so people don't look at you. Here in New Hampshire, it's so funny, I would be in the McLaren or the Cullinan or the Lambo or whatever and people would be taking pictures and taking videos of me everywhere I went and so it got really annoying. I'll take you in the garage, show you a couple of the cars that I have. It's nothing too crazy, but I love both of them. It's probably about the top of the ceiling of the extent of cars that I would keep in New Hampshire. and not draw a crazy amount of attention to myself. So, well, check it out. Here we got a 2021 first edition Range Rover. I'll tell you, I've had a lot of SUVs. I still have a 2022 Range Rover, it's brand new. And I still have a 2021 Black Badge Cullinan in Miami. Here's a very surprising fact. I was surprised by it. I love this thing. I actually enjoy driving this Range Rover much more than I do during the Cullinan, the Rolls Royce. So this is a daily drive. And then this car was one of my, I've had it forever. This is one of my very first luxury cars, one of my very first six-figure vehicles that I ever purchased. And this is an S63 AMG Mercedes-Benz. So look inside. Beautiful car. Yeah, I love this car a lot. And so, you know, nice cars, but low-key enough. They're not gonna draw a crazy amount of attention. Can move around with all the eyeballs, but still very, very nice. Let's go check out the game though. You guys want to check out the game room? Let's see. Some lights on here. Man. So we used to have, you know, when I spent more time in New Hampshire, we'd have a lot of parties, a lot of events, you know, have fun in this room, hang out, play some ping pong, play pool. I don't drink alcohol. I don't do any drugs. I've been sober a long time, but we get the bar. And so we drink seltzer waters and whatnot. Check this out. I'll show you. And look at this view too. Anywhere you got the house. So here in the game room above the mantle, I have this chainsaw. And I'll tell you a story about it. It means a lot to me. I grew up, my father raised me almost entirely alone from the age of 12, 13 on. And he owned a tree removal and logging company. And when I turned 12, he got me my very first chainsaw. Cutting trees down for a living is a brutal way of making money. I actually have a picture over there that I'll show you in a minute. This chainsaw, because cutting trees down was a generational thing, meaning that my grandfather did it, my father did it, and I did it. This is the chainsaw that my grandfather gave my father for his 12th birthday. And so I keep it there, so when I'm chilling in this room, it's a really good reminder, a reflection of where we came from. I'm so grateful that I was the one in my family lineage to be able to break out and break out of the work boots and really take things to the next level. And so this is a very amazing reminder of who we are and where we came from, right? Let me show you this picture. Here's a picture of my father that I have hung up. And that's him and his log truck. And growing up, I used to sit on the side, you know, 7, 8, 9 years old, I'd be on these job sites and he'd give me little jobs to do, picking up sticks and piling stuff up. But I sat in the front of this log truck for more time than I can count. And some of the best conversations and guidance that I received from my dad growing up happened in that log truck. And just, you know, the visibility of fatherhood, of teaching your son something, and I try to do this with both of my boys, by watching action. And so by, you know, watching what we do with our actions. We'll listen to what they say, but they watch what you do. And these lessons are they're caught, not taught, right? These jobs were very difficult. They were very dangerous. Cutting down trees for a living is hazardous work. They always presented a bunch of problems. And I look back and it really gave me the opportunity to never give up, always find a solution to the problem, always deploy work ethic, and, you know, just work until the job is done, no matter what. And so, it's one of my favorite pictures.
Yeah.
guys want to see a really cool feature of this house? I'm going to show you. I love when it lights up like that. Check this out. We got 12 seats in the movie theater here. This is one of my favorite features of this house, right? It's a great entertaining space. If you watch sports, this is a great place to do it. Myself, I'm a big boxing and UFC fan, so I've had countless fight nights. Invite a handful of the homies over and order a bunch of food and sit down here and talk wreck and watch the fights. And you can also play, Xbox or whatever it is on this large screen, which is a lot of fun. And so we play, Call of Duty and things like that, set up in the front with the controllers, and that's a good time as well. But I got a secret for you though, if you can guess it. I don't watch a lot of TV. I don't watch a lot of movies. I just spend more time working, and so I don't actually spend too much time down here. I know I keep saying this, but this is really, really the biggest attraction to this house is this outdoor space in the backyard. This is one of my favorite places to sit. I spend more time in this seat right here than I do probably anywhere else. If you watch some of my more recent YouTube videos, I shot them right here. This outdoor kitchen, I'll show you. We got seating for a bunch. I love to entertain. I love, all the money, all the wealth, all the toys, all of that stuff is cool and enjoyable. But if you don't have quality people in your life, man, you're rich in money but poor in spirit. I just had this new grill installed. We used the last one so much that I wore the thing out. So this is a brand new grill. As you can see, it gets used frequently. It's one of the things I do love. I love just firing this thing up, getting some quality meats from the butcher shop and just getting after it, right? This pool is very comfortable. It's heated and so it's very warm. We have the hot tub over there. We have the pool house, which has a little bar with refreshments, a little chill area, and the air conditioner to get out of the heat. It also has a full bathroom with a shower. Out back here, we have this pond. I don't own the pond, but I'm one of two houses that is actually has access and is on this pond. And so we put a dock in down there. What we used to have was that we had that boat and me and my son would go out there. We'd do a lot of fishing, chilling out on the water, which was really fun. Some great memories of him growing up, had a blast doing it. Last thing to show you guys, we've seen most of the house. The last thing I have to show you is probably the most useless feature for me of the house, which is the tennis court. I don't play tennis. I want to learn. Any of you tennis instructors, get after me, all right? Come teach me how to play. So you see this plaque. This actually has nothing to do with me. We just never had it replaced, but the former owner of this house, who actually built it, the first owner of this house, I should say, built this tennis court for their daughter. You got this beautiful tennis court. I've been saying for years, one of those things over and over again, that I'm going to take some tennis lessons and learn how to play. A lot of people I know and respect in life and business are advocate tennis players. Listen guys, thank you for coming along on the tour of my home. I appreciate you spending your time with me. Please give a like on the video, leave a comment, and also subscribe to my channel. Keep your eyes open. We're gonna put out probably about a month or so, we'll be doing the home tour of my Miami mansion. And that is a beautiful spot right on the water in the Venetian Islands of Miami. Show you both of my places. And I wanna be impeccably clear about why I'm showing you this. People are like,
oftentimes in the comments and the messages, they think this is anything about showing off. This isn't about showing off. It's about showing up. It's about showing all of you what's possible. It's no compliment to me to share my life openly with you. And the only reason I do it is to inspire you, to tell you my story of where I came from, and then show you how I'm really living authentically. Like, you know, what is going on in my life, because it's going to show you all what's possible. Oh yeah, each and every person is meant for greatness. You're meant for excellence, and getting aligned with that purpose and putting the work in, you have no idea how cool your life can be. So listen, like, comment, subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, share it with a friend. I appreciate you. Stay solid.